What's the difference between this coral and this coral? Nothing, they're the same coral. They're clones. That's right, this coral was broken off this one, and then they've grown to become their very own living organisms. The technical term for this process is called micro-fragmenting, and it's being used to save dying coral reefs around the world, many of which have taken centuries to grow. All of these corals behind me are clone corals. Coral reefs are basically the rainforest of the ocean. About 25% of the ocean's fish depend on healthy coral reefs. We, humans, also need them. In fact, more than 500 million people depend on reefs for food, income, and protection. But our reefs are dying. We've lost more than half of the world's coral since the 1950s. There seems to be hope though. Microfragmented corals could slow down or even reverse the loss of corals around the world, since they can reportedly grow 25 to 50 times faster than the normal rate. So, I want to know, is microfragmenting an easy process? Can we clone all corals? And can it be scaled up enough to restore reefs around the world? Let's find out. On this episode of Can It Save the Planet, I'm going to talk to Dr. David Vaughn and his daughter Dee Dee of Plant a Million Corals to learn how to clone corals, their efforts to restore dying reefs, and ultimately find out if cloning corals can save the planet.
I believe that corals, like the poor polar bear in the Arctic, are the first organisms showing the stress from climate change.
Presented by Honda.
Along with the Arctic ice melting and the increase in historic droughts, you've probably seen many headlines about the coral reefs dying due to rising temperatures. For many people, it's out of sight, out of mind, since we don't all live in a coastal area. But as I mentioned, they are dying. Climate change isn't the only enemy that corals are battling. Pollution, habitat destruction, and overfishing are also big threats. And it should come as no surprise that us, humans, are at the heart of the problem. Scientists estimate that by 2030, 90% of the world's coral reefs will be threatened if we don't take action. Thankfully, there are organizations and people like Dr. David Vaughn and his daughter Dee Dee working to restore these valuable reefs and achieve their goal of taking certain species off the endangered list in under a decade. But how exactly do you create a colony of corals from tiny pieces of just one? I'm here in Key West to find out. As I walked into the Plant a Million Corals facility and spoke to David, I couldn't help but feel hope that this solution to restoring reefs could work. David has cloned and planted 100,000 corals since he accidentally broke a coral and saw it regrow in 2006. He calls this his eureka mistake.
I had been working on one of the first test tube corals from sexual reproduction that had gotten 3 years old up to about this size. And I was disappointed it was too slow. I moved them to a tank, and in the process, I broke one into a number of pieces. What happened is they grew back to that same size in weeks instead of months or years. So I took a scalpel like any good scientist and started the experiment over again.
David claims developing a mature coral head the size of a large pizza would typically take 25 to 75 years. But with their process, they're able to do it in just a couple years.
If we take one coral the size of a pepperoni and we cut it into 20 little pepperonis, 6 months later, they'll grow up to the same size. And if we put them in a circle like a medium-sized pizza, they will grow back together and will have formed a 25 to 100-year-old coral in literally 2 years.
Wow. How do you cut them? What kind of tools do you use?
People have been making a specialized saw to make coral jewelry. We use the same saw. It's not rocket science, but since we make little rocks, I like to call it rockette science.
And these aren't just any clones. They are building an Olympic team of survivors.
We've lost half the world's corals because of climate change. But the half of the corals that are still alive are resistant or resilient to today's conditions. So we just need to make more of those.
So this is a good stopgap, but can it be scaled as a solution? David told me they originally faced some issues getting recognition in scientific journals, as well as the proper permits to conduct microfragmenting, but they got over that hump.
We had to show people it in front of their face, and once they see it, it's believing.
The second hurdle with scaling up is equipment, but David and team are already solving that problem too.
Those fiberglass tanks you see around me sometimes take 6 weeks to 6 months to get one. We can take the corals in one tank and cut them into 20 pieces each. We now need 20 more tanks the next day. We're solving some of that with a new tank design.
How do you measure if an ecosystem's thriving?
We now know to look at the fish, the sounds of the invertebrates, and all the other organisms. And if you start to see the whole ecosystem build up, that's success.
David says at the rate in which they're growing, they'll be able to grow 1 million corals annually beginning in late 2023.
A number of people have asked me, why don't you wait till all the pollutants, all the stressors are settled and then start planting? And I asked them this question, if you can tell me a date that all the stressors are solved, including climate change, I will wait for that date. No one can tell you that date. So in the meantime, we're trying to keep a living reef existing.
So now that we know what the process is like, we're going to learn how to do it ourselves.
Didi, thank you so much for having us. So what's the process like? Where
do we begin? So we're gonna take this piece of coral and we're gonna cut it off of this plug. Now what we do is we can take this one and make lots of other baby corals. What do you think? You ready to cut a coral?
I'm ready to play surgeon, yes.
Okay. Keep your fingers out of the way of the saw.
That's not the content we want to produce here.
There you go.
Nice.
You just cloned a coral.
Okay. All right, so then we just put it in the water.
Mm-hmm. They're gonna start to respond, just like if we got cut, we're gonna bleed. So just make sure they're not getting covered by anything so that they can keep being happy and healthy coral. Now we're
gonna super glue them.
Yes, so we put them on these plugs. A little dollop of super glue. Down in the water they go. And they'll grow together and not fight because they're all from the same original coral.
They'll be like, hey.
Yeah, I know you.
Yeah, I know you. Do they have to connect? Is it like connect four? Are we playing a game here?
Well, that was easy. Easier than cloning a tree, I'd say.
All right,
you
I got,
it.
Finally.
So it's time to answer the big question. Can cloning corals save the planet? Before we get to our conclusion, I'd like to take a moment to thank Honda for sponsoring this episode.
Honda's vision for carbon neutrality by 2050 is what we call triple action to zero. Zero emissions, resource circulation, and zero waste. First part of zero emissions means no CO2 emitted in the making of our products. That means Honda's facilities and all of our suppliers. That also means the biggest part, 80% of CO2 emissions for transportation are in the use of the vehicles in mobility. So we'll procure clean energy for that. Resource circulation means making new Hondas out of old Hondas, and that means zero waste. Of course, cars have to be fun to drive too. So we're really doing a balancing act of making sure our cars have good performance, but also responsible for the environment. My first Honda was a Civic, and Civic has always been a hallmark of fun to drive, incredible packaging, good fuel efficiency, and low emissions. I currently have an S2000 that I love driving. It always puts a smile on my face and either has my kids giggling or squealing, depending how I'm driving. We genuinely believe that our commitment to triple action to zero will help change the industry and help change the world. We help democratize safety features for everyone. Years ahead of the regulations on any of those safety features, and we like being able to democratize clean energy, democratize low CO2 emissions by changing the playing field. We're about 10% of the U.S. market. We carry enough weight that we can change the equation for the whole industry.
Now, back to the episode.
Now let's do a quick recap of what we've learned. Number one, clone corals can grow 25 to 50 times faster than normal coral. Number two, thousands of new corals can be grown in a very small area. And number three, this process can be scaled up across the world. So, can cloning corals help save the planet? Yes. Cloning corals can specifically help slow down or even reverse dying coral reefs. However, it's not a fix-all solution. We still have a lot of other things to fix if we even want these resilient corals to survive, like reducing pollution, ending overfishing, and limiting fossil fuel consumption, which reduces carbon emissions and therefore reduces ocean warming. There are some skeptics that have concerns about scalability and species diversity. When it comes to diversity, David says they avoid monocultures by having at least 3 to 5 genetic strains for every species when fragmenting corals. It's important to remember that they're also specifically cloning resilient corals, so they'll survive changing ocean conditions. As for this process being scalable, there are 11 case studies that David has gathered in his book, all showing that this can be scaled globally. As for real challenges, both David and Didi say funding is always an issue to scale up their efforts, but they've received support from foundations and private individuals to further their coral growing mission. They're even making transportable coral nurseries in a box, which they ship to other people and organizations around the world. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go take a look at the coral over there and see how far they've come. I swear, I'm getting so much cute aggression from them. Oh, baby.
This looks like an edible mushroom, to be honest.
Yeah, no nibbling.